guys, welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Jenny Wangoi. If you are new here, please welcome. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you for being here and thank you for subscribing to my YouTube channel. You guys have gotten me to 2.4 subscribers, so thank you so much. And if you're watching this and you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button because that helps my channel grow and it also helps me create more educational videos. So on today's video, as you can see from the title of the video, I'm going to be talking about green cards. The things that I'm going to be talking about on this video are the things that I personally wish that I really knew more about, rather than just kujua ile ya juju. These are the things that I really wish I knew more details about before coming here, or I really wish somebody educated me ile one-on-one, like a student ile ni kama mwalimu na mwanafunzi, so for me to make better decisions. So if you are watching this, please watch up to the end. Even if you're not planning on maybe applying for the green card, maybe it will make you make a better decision of not applying for the green card, or for maybe deciding to apply for the green card, or maybe recommend somebody that you feel a green card might help. So what's a green card? A green card is simply a diversity visa, and throughout this video I'm going to be saying the do's and the don'ts when you are applying for the green card, and the misinformation zenye watu kuwa nazo about a green card. Almost probably nitakuwa naongea Kiswahili better part of this video, because I really want to talk to my friends that are asking about the diversity visa. I want to talk to my clients at Nailed. I want to talk to my family. I want to talk to my relatives. I want to talk to you who has been following me and has been wishing to come to the US and does not know where to start. And this is actually where you should really start, by applying for a diversity visa. So the other day, I've always had people ask me on which the best way to come to the US. I've had people tell me, invite me to the US. I've had my cousins, I've had my nephews tell me to help them how to come here. And most of the times, even if you have relatives here, or even sisters and brothers, sometimes they might not be in a position to grant you that assurance to come here, because also, in as much as somebody invites you or gives you the go ahead, all the decision is decided by the embassy, where you meet the consular, answer questions and all of that. And most of the other processes that you need to come to the US require money, and a lot of money. The green card haihitaji pesa when you are applying, but also it's not free once you win. Okay, once you win, sio bure. But I tell people is that if ile stress uko nayo saa hii ni kuhusu sasa nikishinda green card sijui mtu US, sasa nikishinda green card hata sina pesa za kwenda US. See, let's worry about that when that time comes. Right now it's just applying. It's just applying. When we win, we will cross that bridge when we get there. Okay? So today I just want to say the mistakes that even for me maybe I was doing when I was doing my application, or because I actually remember, when was it? Was it in 2019? I had a close friend who was in the US, and they told me to apply for the green card. They were just like, Jenny, by the way, will you apply green card? I was like, oh no. And I'm able to apply your kitu. The same thing that I'm telling my friends, able to apply your kitu. So they told me that. I remember at that time I was in Mombasa. I think nilivaa tu sijui nini nikaingia studio fulani hapo Mombasa. They didn't even have the correct background, and I applied for the green card. I remember it was like one day before ifungwe, and I just didn't win. And now I understand why probably I did not win, because maybe the photo that I submitted had not met the requirements, which that's the major thing. Also, that time back in 2019, they needed you to have a passport. This year you do not even need a passport. So wezi kunasema sita apply hiyo kitu juu hata sina passport ama maybe nikishinda sina hata passport. If you win that, if you apply that thing right now in October, which you have from it started on 4th of October na itafungwa November, that's 1 month to apply. Then they close that website, which will be down below. Then they close that website until now next year time like now. But sasa kushinda, watu watashinda. Announcing ya wale watu wameshinda will happen next year, 2024 May. So you have a lot of time to now plan about maybe the passport and a few more things that might be needed just in case you win. And either way, you're saying you want to come to the US, then you need to start working on a passport. At least that's the bare minimum of coming to the US. So anyway, I posted about the green card when the site opened, which was on Wednesday. As I'm recording this, today is on a Friday. So it was opened 2 days ago. And it runs up until November. I think I've already mentioned that. Kuna gari ya polisi inapita. So good. I have to wait for that noise to be. As we do that, let me sip my soda. I think now it's much better. So what was I saying? So it runs up until November. So you have a whole month to do the application. And just one thing that I say to people is that you're playing the green card to win. You're not just playing the green card for the sake of it. You are playing to win. So if I knew that, I think that time when for me I was applying, nilikuwa na apply tu juu nimeambiwa. Juu nimeambiwa ni apply tu ninasema, let me just do it. Let me just do it. But I just feel like people need more information before they decide if they want to apply for the green card or if they don't want to apply for the green card. And that's exactly what I'll be doing in this video. Nilikuwa nimepost, if you follow me on my socials, nilikuwa nimepost the links and all that and the requirements. And I had a few people ask me questions, and I saw some of the questions zenye walikuwa nauliza. They're also the questions that I personally had. But one question that I really was disappointed someone asking me, and these are people who wamekuwa wakiniambia, aki Jenny nataka kukuja US, aki Jenny nataka kukuja US. So I feel like some basic knowledge someone should know when you're deciding if you want to come to the US is like the different type of visas that are there, because uwezi kuwa tu uko hapo and you're saying unataka kwenda US. US kusema ukweli, US kusema naenda Kisumu, that I only need bus fare to get there. There are so many processes that you need to go through before coming to the US. And so the diversity visa makes it easier for you to come here as compared to any other type of visa. As a matter of fact, there's a kuna this nephew of mine that has really been telling me, and I'm really praying for him to come here. But now I posted about the green card, and the first question he asked me was like, koi green card ni nini? And I was like, oh my God, okay. That means you want to come to the US, but you also don't understand the type of visas that are there to come to the US, which is just maybe hajaenda aka research. And well, that's why I'm here with a broad eye with Jenny to explain to you what a green card really means and what a green card can do to you and the benefits and maybe the pros and the cons simply. Nimesema hii video nitaongea Kiswahili mingi kwa sababu sitaki watu wa Trump wakuwe disappointed. A diversity visa is a visa that the US government came up with so that it can give opportunity to different people all around the world to come and benefit in America, to just be in America. So what the US government is doing is that it's giving you an opportunity to come have a better chance in America, it doesn't mean that because umeshinda green card that now you are everything is under the US government. Ati utakuja hapa, US government inakupatia chakula, inakulipia rent, inakufanyia nini. What the US government does, once it has given you the diversity visa, it's giving you an equal opportunity just as a US citizen. And so US as a whole and as a country, they try to bring people all around the world so that there is diversity, for lack of another better word, or to just intermingle of different cultures. Yeah, different cultures. So you'll find different countries are given the opportunity to play this diversity visa, and the number of people that the US government gives every year is 55,000 visas. They give 55,000 visas all over the world. Of course, there are countries that are not permitted to play the green card. Izo sita wadanganya that ninajua ni countries gani. I am not sure about those countries. But sahi ninataka tu kuongelesha wa Kenya wenzangu ama East Africans. So I know East Africa as a whole, you can play the diversity visa. One country that I know for sure cannot apply is Pakistan. I don't know any other country. Iyo sijui. And what I don't know, I'm not going to talk about in this video, but what I know for sure, what I'm going to be talking about in this video is what I know for sure. What I know for sure, even if you call a US lawyer or attorney, this is the exact information that you're going to get. It's only that mimi ninawaletea I habari so that you see that it's from somebody maybe you probably know, or I am putting it in layman's language. Once the US government gives you this diversity visa, the advantages of the US giving you this diversity visa is that once you win the diversity visa and get and all your paperwork may go through and you get to come to the US, they give you permanent residence. They give you a permanent residence. If you ask anyone, if you have friends from the US or you know anyone that has been in America, they're going to tell you that being in America with as a permanent resident is far much better than being here as a student or with any other type of visa, because the other form of visas are going to require you to do so much work as compared to a permanent resident. Unafika hivi airport, kama US government na joko hapa, they give you a work permit. See, you know, people assume that once you win the green card, unafika airport kama US government imekwambia, oh, in Kenya, you are a banker. Aya, kuja basi nikupatie kazi kwa bank. That's not how it works. So what the US government does, it gives you an opportunity. It gives you and your family an opportunity to be in this country. And it's because they know that you stand a better chance maybe to be in a first world country. If you feel that maybe being in a first world country will not do you or your family any better, then you are far much better being in Kenya, so that's still fine. But if you're watching this video and you know anyone that has been saying mina ezataka kwenda US, maybe this is their chance to try their luck. Wewe ujui baraka zako ziko wapi. Maybe umekuwa ukihustle Kenya na maybe hustle yako haitajipa ukiwa Kenya because your blessings are in America. So I don't see why you should not apply for a green card. If you have the desire to maybe move to America, you should probably apply for a green card. And so throughout this video, I'll be talking about the mistakes that people make when applying for the green card and maybe how else you can, the confusions zenye ziko or confusions zenye ziko ama makosa zenye watu ufanya wakifanya hiyo application. Okay, I'm going to start with the, I hope so far now you have understood what a diversity visa is. And something that maybe I should mention before I hop into the requirement is that even if right now where you are there uko Kenya and you are working to get maybe another form of visa, I don't know what type of visa you are working on getting, maybe you even have an embassy date, applying for a green card does not affect any of that. Because even if you apply and maybe get a visiting visa, na maybe uliko umecheza green card and win the green card and probably your paperwork, your green card goes very well, then that's a better chance as compared to being to any other form of visa that you are applying for. That one, you can take it from me, that's for sure. And that's why it's free, and it's just a matter of luck. Hakunanga atikujuana ati US, wanajua nani. It's just bahati, ni kama venye unaweza cheza. Hizi vitu zinaitangu aje. Like I remember when I was young, mamangu alikuwa ananituma kwenda chama. Alafu kwa hiyo chama munaekewa vitu kama, they are like numbers, zinarushwa ndani, and then the first, you just pick the number and the one yenye umeshinda. That is just how the diversity visa works. Ni bahati yako. Na ujui, maybe Mungu, nini yako ndo ita, jina yako ndo itachukuliwa hiyo time. But for you, your name to be amongst the names that are being considered to be given the diversity visa, you have to do the right application. Because the moment you don't do the application the right way, as they have indicated in their website, then they don't, ata ufikangi ile stage ya kukua considered ati now we are, usha kuwa disqualified before even they start choosing. The system has already removed you there. So unapatanga kama maybe let's say in Kenya, maybe 100 people wali apply, but only maybe 50 people wali apply the right way. So the US government is only considering those 50,000. Wewe zenyu zenye mulifanya makosa, they don't consider them. And that's why I'm here to tell you that anything that they have listed there, please do it by the books. So first thing that I want to mention is that in this year when you're playing the green card, they don't require you to have a passport. Hawahitaji ukuwe na passport. So if you do not have a passport, you don't need to be worried that hauna passport, nini. You can just apply for it, and then after the application, because zinatokanga next year, you can just do all the other works that you need to do. Now on to the photo. The photo yenye wanasemanga utoe, the photo yenye wanasemanga that it's a photo passport. Ni passport photo. And that passport photo needs to be taken on a white background. They say white or cream background. So it needs to be on a white background. So if you go there, uchukue picha kwa green background, we ushakuwa disqualified. Ushakuwa disqualified. That photo has measurements, which is 2x2. And then it has to be 240 kb. Just make sure that your photo meets that requirement. And for example, if you are applying, tuseme kama wewe uko na watoto wenye una applya pia, ama maybe your husband, isikuwe wewe picha yako ndio imefikisha requirements, but ya watu wengine haijafikisha requirements. Because that one also can disqualify you. Just make sure that the photo ya wewe na your dependent iko the right size the right requirements also apply to everyone that unaeka kama dependent. So when you're taking this passport photo, make sure, kama unaenda kwa mtu wa kukupiga passport photo, just make sure you tell them, like, it doesn't matter kama utashinda umemrudia, this passport photo ni ya kuapply green card. Tell them that I need this photo to be a 2x2. Show them, waonyeshe, siya tunaenda. I'm assuming uko hapo, let me use Nyeri, ndio mtu asiseme nimewa-attack, wacha nitumie kwetu. Saki mtu wako hapo Nyeri, umeingia tu mahali, umepigwa tu picha yoyote, and then unaanza kui-crop, and that's the photo that you're going to use. Remember, you're playing a green card to win. I'll play to just, naitango aje, for better, auchezi kuhigia wadho, you're doing it to win, so you'd rather just do it the right way. And then when you're taking that passport photo, kama unavaanga glasses, make sure you don't have your glasses on. It's just a passport photo, dakika moja, umetoa glasses, umepigwa picha, umerudisha your glasses. Make sure you're not wearing a hat. If you wear nini zinaitangwaje, hearing aids, kama unavaanga hearing aids, you can have your hearing aids on, that's allowed, but also it doesn't harm, this is now my personal advice. Hearing aids ni sawa, but for the sake of that passport photo, unaweza zitoa, upigwe passport photo, uzirudishe. Passport photo ni dakika mbili umerudisha. If you wear things like a turban, ama ini ni ya Waislamu, sijui inaitangwa aje, ikitu ya Waislamu, that those ones are allowed because those are a display of religion. The US recognizes religion. So hizo unaweza kuwa nazo as long as hazikufuniki, like usikuwa umevaa hizo vitu na zimekufunika part of your face, like make sure the, your face inaonyeshana vizuri, masikio zako zinaonekana vizuri. Even if you're wearing those things, that cannot disqualify you, but just make sure that that photo is showing your facial features vizuri, and especially the ears. If the person that is taking your passport photo hajachukua vizuri na masikio zako hazionekani, rudia, shinda mkirudia hapo. Also, kwa your website that I'm going to put down here, there is a way before you apply, unaweza weka picha yako to test if it meets the requirements before you apply. So don't rush into applying just for the sake of applying. Take your time to do the right thing. Alafu sasa ndo the rest wachie God. Jewezi kuunambia God nataka kwenda US na hata we ujajisaidia. That's the first step of kujisaidia. That's the first step of kujisaidia. Take the, here are the requirements, meet the requirements. Then now submit your paper, submit your photo there. So that's the first requirement. A photo is very, very important, by the way. Hey, msipuzi. Ama ati unachukua selfie ati unapost. Kama kuna beshte yangu aliniambia ati last year, alipigwa picha hapo kwa nyumba, ati hiyo ndo aliapply nayo. Come on, guys. Like, come on. Unaapply ushinde. So can you... Kuwa hata serious kidogo, hata ukikosa kushinda utajua, nilikosa kushinda kwa sababu I was not selected, but I did the right thing. The other thing that I want to say is that there is no, tasema maximum age, if that's something that he said, maximum age, hakuna age. Either uko 70 years old, you can apply for a green card, hakuna age yenye wamesema, ukifika hii age haufai kuapply, hiyo hakuna. But you have to be 21 years old when you are applying for the green card. Me 21, na confusing 21 na 18 years old, because even the other day I posted on my Instagram na nilisema 18 years old. But now here is the catch. I want to give a scenario. Like let's say you are a parent. When I'm mzazi, let me give an example with maybe my mom is applying and my dad is applying, akona watoto. That's the scenario that I want to put. My mom better not see this. So that's the scenario that you are applying. So what happens, wewe kama mzazi ukiapply, you put, unaweka watoto wako wenye wako below 21 years old. Anyone that is below 21 years old, pia yeye atakuwa your dependent. Atakuwa your dependent. So you apply for them. Mtu mwenye ameshafikisha, mtoto wako mwenye ameshafikisha 21 years old, anaweza apply as an individual. Ya ta apply kama individual. Lakini wewe kama mzazi, kama uko na mtoto mwenye ako below 21 years old, utamu include kama your dependent. Another question that might rise up is that maybe mtoto wako ako 19 years old ama maybe sayi ako 20 years old. What happens due by the time maybe tunashinda next year atakuwa ameshafikisha 21 years old. What the US embassy does is that they know that's a possibility. Hata wao wanajua that's a possibility. So by the time unaenda kusubmit your paperwork, try not to, and that time comes after sasa umeshashinda. Hiyo si mambo unafaa kukua worried about sayi. When that time comes, you just need to prove to them that this person when I was applying alikuwa this age, sahi amefikisha. Awata kukansolia DV yako ati kwa sababu ya that. That cannot happen. Another thing is that I'm trying to remember everything that someone has asked me, so my thought process might be all over the place. So if you don't understand either any of the points that I put across and need more clarification, unaweza niuliza kwa comment session. I know this video is going to be a long one, so I really hope that it serves the purpose of this video. So let's say you and your husband are married. So inaweza kuwa you are married, unajua kuna ile Kenya kuna tunaishi pamoja but hatuko married. There is that kadhi, tunaishi pamoja but we are not married. So in that case, you can decide to apply as a family depending on your marital status, ama you can decide kama huyo mtu no uikarania, you know, ile wanasemanga no uikarania. So so what you can do in that case, chenye unaweza fanya, huyo mzee kama hata kutoka akiwin hiyo green card, anaweza apply peke yake as a single entry. But kwa hiyo single entry, kumbuka ataulizwa, you are asked about family. So atakutaja hapo kwa hiyo nini atakutaja. Wewe kama bibi yake sasa pia wewe, uliamura ikarania na akeri, pia yeye atajaza hiyo DV as a single entry, but atakuwa amejazia watoto wenyu. So what does that give you? It gives you double chances as a family to win that DV. Okay? It gives you double entry for that DV. So imaanishi ati juu bwana aliapply, bibi afai kuapply. No. The only thing that they say is that no double entry. And that means that ukisha apply, usidhani that utaenda tena kwa hiyo website to apply tena mara ya pili na ya tatu, that that increases your chances. That actually cancels your chances. Okay, so I hope, I know people have so many, I feel like most of the questions that I got from my friends or my the people that have my contacts and my followers were about marriage, venye utajaza na nini, so I might talk about that a little bit more when I remember another point that I might not have mentioned, and if you have a question about it, you can as well ask me. Another requirement that is very vital, nimesha sema mambo ya picha. Picha nimewaambia, si picha nimewaambia venye inafaa kukua. Passport nimewaambia ufai kukua na passport, hiyo utajali mambo ya passport, ukisha shinda hii kitu, na sahi passport kwanza zinatoka haraka sana. The other thing that they require from you is a high school diploma. A high school diploma. So, for some people that requirement can be confusing. Because some people assume that a diploma ni yenye, tukiwa Kenya, diploma ni yenye tumepata tukienda college. But as long as umemaliza form 4, kuna ile nini ya form 4. Eh? That is all you need. Hata ushinde hapo ukiwa, kuna mahali utaulizo about your education. Hata useme your education ukona master, hata useme your education sijui uko na masters, sijui uko na degree, sijui uko na nini, that does not increase your chances of winning. It does not increase your chances of winning. Or ati sasa beshte yako anakushtu hapo ati juu yeye ako na degree na wewe hauna ama nini, wewe ulimaliza tu form 4. That's all the US government recognizes, a form 4 certificate. And that's the only thing they will need from you. Umesikia kuna mahali nimetaja ID, Kenyan ID. Sijasema mahali Kenyan ID. Hakuna mahali nimesema birth certificate. Na nowhere nimesema no passport, photo requirement to meet, na sasa high school diploma. High school diploma, that's all. Either ushinde hapo ukiwaambia sijui nilienda USA.It, they don't care. Them they don't care. Them they just want somebody who has finished form 4. Let's assume wewe haukumaliza form 4. Maybe ulifika class 8 tukaacha. So there are people who will tell you, ah, kama hukumaliza form 4, wewe by the way zicheza green card. That's true, but there is also a catch on that. And I want you to get this very right. Wacha ni sip soda ndo munielewe. So kama hukumaliza form 4, what they need from you is 2-year work experience. And that 2-year work experience, you can prove that work experience. 2 years work experience for the last 5 years. For the last 5 years, ukona two years work experience. Na that work experience requires 2 years of training. 2 years work experience in the last 5 years in an occupation that requires 2 years of training. Simply, the best example for you to understand, if you're watching this and you're in this category, the best way to explain it is, maybe ulimaliza class 8, badala ya kuenda high school, ukasema uende ufanye polytechnic. Ukaenda polytechnic kufanya course fulani for, what course is done in a polytechnic? let me think, a course that can take 2 years. Carpentry, maybe? I don't know, I don't have a perfect example right now in my mind. But maybe your course senior ulienda kufanya kwa your training, it took you 2 years, zenye unaweza prove, and you have worked for 2 years, that already in the US, they have a category in the US for that, and they recognize that. Juna patanga US, mtu alimaliza middle school, hakuenda high school, and that is still fine. So the US recognizes that. So kama hauna high school, and you have that, you can still apply. Na hii ni mimi ninawaambia. Kwa hivyo, usiseme ati ile job yenye, unaona venye wanasema 2 years of training. Of course, mimi pia si nimetoka Kenya. Maybe ile course ulienda kufanya, kwa hiyo shule walikuwa wanafanya 1.5 years. Iyo ni Nairobi wewe, cheza kama. Iyo time ikifika ukishinda, wewe cheza hiyo green card. Iyo time ikifika, utajua chenye utafanya. Sitaki kusema hapa, mseme mimi ni mkora. Utajua chenye utafanya. But the only thing you need to prove is that for the last 5 years, umework 2 years na ulienda shule for 2 years to study for that. Usiseme ulienda kufanya baba shop na ulistudy for 6 months, now that will disqualify you. Alright? Those are the only requirements. The major requirements ni hizo. Picha ikuwe sawa, passport haihitajiki, ukuwe na high school diploma, haijalishi ulimaliza hiyo high school lini, either ikuwe ni 1980, wewe kuwa tu na hiyo high school diploma. Kama una hiyo high school diploma, nimesema hiyo 2 years of working experience na in an occupation that they say 2 years work experience in an occupation that requires 2 years of training and have worked for 2 years in the past 5 years. That's simply how they put it, and it can be confusing for a few people, but that's simply what they mean. Yeah, so the other people that ask, kama niko, kama this LGBTQ, maybe kuna wengine wanauliza if I'm HIV positive, if I have other diseases, can I apply for a DV? This application, first of all, before you even ask all these questions, can I apply? As long as you have all those things that I've said, you are eligible to apply. This other step ya kusema mambo ya HIV, LGBTQ, will come when you win. And when you win, kuna hiyo stage ya kuenda kupeana documents, which will come after you win. After you win, maybe, I really hope there are people who will watch this video and win that DV so that I can come back here and advise them on what to do. So I am really rooting for you to win. So can you just please do the right thing? Just do the right thing. I'm trying to see from the questions that are down here. Did I say about the photo? Maybe si kusema hii. Maybe I'm repeating myself, I'm not sure. But about the photo, they said there that the photo that you're going to submit should have been taken 6 months, in a span of the last 6 months. So ile picha yenye ulitumia 3 years ago, usishinde, usirudie. Well, I don't know if the government has a way of knowing kama umerecycle that photo, but what I know for sure, the US go per as the book, so it won't cost you anything. Why would you recycle a photo and you want to win a green card? If you're playing to win, just take a good new photo and submit it. Well, kuna wale watu watakwambia niliapply na the same photo na bado nilishinda. Iyo ni bahati yao. Kuna wale watu tu wanakuanga na bahati. Kuna yule mtu mwenye pia ananiambia, I've been applying for this thing for the last 10 years, jai shinda, hii kitu ni scam. Maybe kuna kitu unafanyanga wrong, that's why you never win. Ama maybe you go apply for that thing. Unaenda kwa cyber, unaambia huyo mtu wa cyber, umesha piga picha, alafu unamuachia kuapplye. How sure are you that person has applied for you? Because what I would advise is that, ukienda kuapply your green card, do it yourself. Even if you don't know how to do, the questions they're asking you there are so basic. There is no rocket science. Kitu rocket science ni hiyo picha tu. Imagine that's the only rocket science. These are the things that they're asking you are very basic. And the answers they are wanting you to give, as long as the answers that you're giving will not contradict when you win the green card, and then now you'll have to go through another whole process of now proving that for real I did not lie. Just don't put contradicting information there, because you also find somebody amekuwa player, maybe alieka kitu akaguess, na sasa that one will affect you. Na ndo maana unapatanga mtu aliwin green card, ameshaambia kijiji mzima, oh by the way mimi naenda US hata nilishinda green card, na maybe kulikuwa na makosa fulani alifanya. Ukiwin green card hiyo come May 2024, unaweza win na bado ukose kukuja because of maybe an application venye ulifanya, maybe venye ulijaza hiyo kitu, information yenye ulipatia did not, the embassy did not feel the need to give you the visa. And that also goes to me saying that US government inapatianga 55,000, inapatiananga 55,000 visas, diversity visa every year, 55,000 visas. Kwa hizi 55,000, what the US government does, it doesn't just give the time yenye watu wana win, wanatoanga watu wengi wenye wame win. So unapata kama 80,000 people have won that green card. This is to make sure that the US government has fulfilled their promise to give 55,000 people. Juu utapata kwa hiyo 55, wakipatia watu 55,000, kuna watu 10,000 walikuwa na apply hawataki kukuja, ama hata wengine something tragic happened to them, wengine hata hawakujua kama waliwin, so they did not confirm. So they get a higher number, which is like maybe 80,000. That's just a number that I'm guessing, that's not the exact number. So that if people cancel, watu wakicancel, bado watabaki na wale 55,000 wao wenye wanataka wakuje. So itakuwa that hii mwaka tunapatia 50,000 people, ama tutapatia 60,000, they always stick to the 55,000 people. And as I said, the US go as per the book. So imagine last year, watu wangapi wenye waliwin Kenyans, 3,700 people won that green card. Watu tu wako hiyo Kenya wali apply na wakawin. What makes you think that you cannot be among those 3,000 people that will win this year if you do it right? And by this 3,700, imagine wao wamewin. Imagine sasa kwa huyo mtu mwenye amewin, how many dependent wamewin? Maybe kwa 37,000, it's double the number because maybe they have family, they have spouses, they have kids who they can move as permanent residents. Did I also mention that if your kid comes to America when you're a permanent resident, that education is free? Education is free from elementary to middle school, like free education. So I don't see why somebody would not take a chance and just play the green card. Whether you win or not, then you can make that decision then. But right now that you have the chance, I would really advise everybody to apply for the green card. Something else that I want to talk about is, I think I mentioned about, if you're not legally married to your other partner, you can apply as an individual. You can apply as an individual, mtakrosi your bridge when you get there. Another thing that people ask is that the time that you apply, I said that today that I'm recording this video is on a Friday, na green card zilianza Wednesday. Utasikia kuna wale watu watakuambia, ukiapply siku za kwanza kwanza, au watu ndio uwin. Utasikia mwingine akikwambia, ukiapply hizi siku za mwisho, au watu ndio uwin. Let me tell you for sure, akunanga eni, there is no order unto which people win. This is luck, hii ni bahati yako. So as long as you apply within the period of time and do it the right way, you stand a chance as mtu mwenye aliapply siku za kwanza, na ule mtu mwenye aliapply hizo the last days. The only thing that I advise is that usingoje, the only thing that I can advise is that usingoje hizo siku za mwisho so that you apply juu. Most people, we are Africans, watu wengi ukimbia the last minute, na so the site might be slow and it might discourage you from applying. But that does not mean that wale watu wali apply wa kwanza, wao ndo wako na a better chance ya kuwin, because people say that. The only bad thing that happens is when you win and your number, because when you win you are given a number, na wanaitanga watu embassy kulingana na hizo number. So that one you cannot dictate the number. After you win, you cannot dictate the number that you are given. But sometimes the number that you are given inaweza kuwa cut. How do I say? Inaweza kuwa cut. Kama wale watu walikuwa wameambiwa wamewin, na maybe sahi, maybe you are watching this na ulikuwa umeambiwa umewin ya last year, na by 30th of September huko umeitwa, then that means you won. but you're not going to come to the US because they have not processed your paperwork and they have already started their other year. So come at our ulkume, we need your time. Apply again for the green card. My dear, apply again because the embassy, they are not going to call you. Kama wakukuita before 30th of September, hawakuiti. My dear, apply for that green card. What else? There is another issue of when you are applying, kuna mahali kwenye utapata wamekuuliza about the address. The address. Note that this address haimaanishi address ya mtu wako US, because I saw somebody ask me on my Instagram to send them my address. They don't require you to have a US address. The US government already know that you are applying for a green card and maybe you don't know anyone. So they are not asking you for an address at this stage of applying. Wanakuuliza your physical address. Na physical address ni zile PO box. PO box, juu za nini PO box. Kama hauna PO box, guess, andika tu PO box yoyote. Juni address tu yoyote, they just want an address. The only thing that is so important after you apply is that confirmation number. Now that's why I'm saying that hata ukiapplywa na mtu wa cyber, make sure that uko na hiyo confirmation number. Your confirmation number ndio utaenda kuconfirm nayo kama ulishinda come May 2024. But hizi vitu zingine za kusema ati what was I saying? I've lost track of my thought. Oh, the address, ati lazima uko unajua na, lazima uko unajua mtu US na address. This is not the point where they need you to know anyone in the US. That time will come after you have won. Izo si any of your worries right now. You will figure that out when you are looking for somebody that you know who is in the US or the address or whatever. You'll worry about that because there's a stage that they will ask you, do you know anyone in the US? What else do I want to talk about? I said about recycling a photo. Oh, by the way, I should have said that when you come to the US, when you win this green card and you come to the US, another benefit is that once you come to the US, you can invite your relatives and they can come here and also enjoy the benefits of a permanent resident. So tuseme wewe umewin, maybe wewe umewin, maybe mzazi wako amewin na wewe mtoto wako, maybe mamako, and that's why I'm saying you advise more people to apply. Maybe if you as a family want to come here, you can find that mamako ame apply na wewe mtoto wake maybe uko 30 years old, eh? So unaona wewe utakuwa umejiapplya peke yako, but mamako aliapply akawin. Your mom has the liberty to invite you to come to the US as a permanent resident. Sometimes it will take a while, but you will also get to benefit from her being a permanent resident. What else? And that applies to any son and daughters who are also above 21 years old, by the way. I wanted to say about there is someone who is watching and ako hapa US and is wondering kama pia yeye anaweza apply for the green card. So, yes, you can apply. If you're already in the US, then you already understand the benefits of being a permanent resident when I'm talking about it. But you're also wondering if you are eligible to apply for this green card. So, there are different... I don't know how you came to the US. I don't know your status or how you came to the US. So, the catch is, as long as you are in the US and has continued to maintain your status, then you can apply for the green card. If you have continued to, maybe you came here as a visitor, but every time you renew your I-94, so that means that you have continued to stay in status, then you can apply for the green card. And by saying that you have stayed in status does not mean that you have that you have asylum. That means that whatever state you came in the US, you have really maintained that status. Because an asylum gives you a legal stay in the US, but you're not lawfully in the US, you're just legally in the US, if that makes sense. The US has allowed you to stay in the US, but bado hawataki kukupatia permanent resident. So simply what I mean is that if you are here na ulikuja uka apply maybe asylum, maybe that means you uli drop your other status and you are on a different status. In that case, you might not be eligible for this type of DV. But if you came here and still continued to maintain your status either as a visitor or as a student, then you can apply for that. You can apply for that green card. Hey, the last one before I leave, the last one. If you are there, if you are a Kenyan man or a Kenyan girl, and maybe your spouse or your husband or your wife is in the US, na pia yeye has been telling you that is applying for you, your paperwork to come here. Applying for a green card does not affect any of that. So you can just still go ahead and apply for that green card, even if your spouse is still filing for you your paperwork. Well, I'm not sure if I covered everything that you have been confused about the green card. I really hope this video helps you make a better decision to apply for that green card. I would really advise that you don't rush into apply for the green card when you're not sure of all the details. So please make sure when you're applying for it, you're doing it right, just to increase your chances of winning. And if you have been playing for the green card na pia haujawahi win, maybe this is your year of winning, and I'm manifesting that to you. And me putting out this video does not mean that kukuja America ni kumake it. It's just giving you a better opportunity. I feel like people in Kenya complain. Okay, people in Kenya, we complain about job opportunities a lot. And something that shocked me when I first came to America and still shocks me up to date is that everywhere you go, unapatanga tu jobs, unapata tu wana advertise. And the first time that I went, there's a time I went to a restaurant and I was there with some other Americans. And can you imagine that a few businesses had been closed down, a restaurant and a few other businesses, zilikuwa zimefungwa just because they don't have employees. And that's a valid reason. Unauliza mtu mbona biashara ilifungwa juu hatuna watu wa kufanya kazi. And I was like, hold up, what do you mean? And these people are like, oh, makes sense. And I was like, no, it doesn't make sense. So that is how much, there is so much work in America. And work in America, you're paid per hour. So if you've been struggling maybe to get a job, or maybe you want to advance your studies in America, getting a permanent residency is a really, really good opportunity for you. A very, very good opportunity for you. Or even if you want your kids to go to school in America, then applying for a green card is a very good opportunity for you. And I highly advise that you go for it. So I'm wishing you all the best as you pop out to go apply for that green card. And if this is what you are praying God to do in your life this year, I am really, really praying that He does that. But before He does that, lazima kwanza ujisaidie. And this is the first step of doing the job and leaving the rest to God. So thank you guys. If I haven't covered anything, please comment down below and make sure you follow me on my social media. Instagram is JennyWangoi_, Facebook is Wangoi Wakabi, and my TikTok, which I'm not yet sure how that works, is Jenny Wangoi. So until the next one, guys, thank you so much. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment down below. And if you feel that this video could benefit someone, just share the link, and I hope it was helpful. Bye.